Fireworks. They're popular entertainment and often set off at parties, tourist attractions, and during holidays by governments, business owners, and private citizens. But could fireworks be bad for animals? If you've ever owned a dog or known someone with a dog, then you're probably familiar with the idea of a thunder shirt. These pieces of doggy clothing are intended to make a dog feel safe by holding them tightly while scary noises like thunder or fireworks are happening. However, not all dog owners use thunder shirts, and these devices don't work for all dogs. Approximately 45% of all pet dogs seem to demonstrate at least some fear of firework noise, and dogs that are scared can engage in negative or dangerous behaviors like barking or whining, peeing, pooping, or vomiting inside, biting or scratching, or trying to hide or run away. Fear can be a powerful emotion. Constant agitation has been shown to shorten animal lifespans and reduce quality of life, even when the stimulus is short and well after it happens. Tests with lab rats have shown that physical and psychological damage are linked to unpredictability and inability to escape or control their environment. It's important to remember that pet cats can also be afraid of fireworks and may engage in any of these same fear-based behaviors. Cats and other animals may not always be able to express their emotions as well as dogs, but that doesn't mean their fear is any less. It's especially dangerous when pets try to hide or run away from firework noise, as they can get hurt or stuck in hiding places or hit by cars if they run away outside. While many vets might prescribe sedatives for animals afraid of fireworks, the best thing a pet owner can do is provide a safe and quiet place in the home for their pets to hide, or work on desensitization training for more extreme fear. But pets aren't the only animals I worry about. Can wild animals be scared by fireworks too? Probably. Fear of fireworks in wild animals is much more difficult to measure because they're less easy to observe than pets or animals in zoos. However, imagine if you were a bird in a nest or a rabbit in a hole near a site where industrial fireworks were being set off. I think I'd be pretty scared in that situation. If a wild animal engages in fear behavior like trying to run away from fireworks, it puts itself at the same risk for injury by being hit by a car as a dog or a cat would. Additionally, an animal fleeing its own territory in fear could wind up in the territory of a rival, putting it at risk for fighting with other members of its own species or being eaten by predators. Not to mention that our discussion so far has been based only on the loud, scary noises caused by fireworks. Researchers interested in this problem have admitted that other components of fireworks, like changes in heat, pressure, light, and smells, could affect animals in ways we just don't know. So the boom from a firework comes from an explosive combustion or burning that pushes it up into the air. Besides all of the normal air pollution problems caused by the smoke from burning something, the mixture that pushes fireworks skyward includes a chemical that we should be concerned about. Perchlorates are chemicals made of chlorine and oxygen mixed with other elements. These chemicals react easily with other chemicals, which makes them good at propelling fireworks, but also makes them good at reacting with the chemicals inside living things. Scientists have found that perchlorates can change the way your thyroid gland works in your body. In humans, they can change the uptake of iodine by the thyroid, causing a condition called hypothyroidism. In other animals, like rats and mice in laboratories, perchlorates have even been shown to increase their chances of thyroid cancer. Speaking of cancer, many of the metals that make the colors of fireworks are also carcinogenic, or at least poisonous. Cadmium, a metal used to make several coloring agents for fireworks, can damage your lungs, your stomach, your kidneys, your bones, and can cause cancer. Cadmium can also be bioaccumulated in plants and animals, which means it can travel through the food web of an ecosystem, increasing in concentration as it goes. This is important since many top predators can accumulate toxic levels of the substance even if it's relatively rare in the environment. Some of these top predators, like fish, including tuna and swordfish, are eaten by humans. Others, like wolves, eagles, and bears, are important parts of ecosystems and our natural heritage. Barium, another metal, makes bright white fireworks when it burns. While barium may not cause cancer in humans and other animals, it can still be deadly. Depending on the amount of barium an animal consumes, it could cause digestive problems and muscle weakness, or more serious symptoms like trouble breathing, nerve issues, and abnormal heartbeat. There are lots of other possible chemical combinations that could be dangerous. Unfortunately, there aren't many regulations on what can or can't be put in fireworks, nor are there definitive studies on all of the possible chemical combinations that may be present after combustion, partially because new chemical combinations are being made all the time in the search for new and interesting colors and special effects like crackling, whistling, and secondary explosions. So what happens when the chemicals from fireworks make it into the water supply? Any animals, wild or domestic, and any humans that drink from that water are at risk for any and all of these negative effects. But how bad are they, and how many people and animals could be affected each time a fireworks display is set off? These are questions that are difficult for scientists to study. Although all of the fear and chemical health stuff is bad, there are also some interesting animal behavior principles at play when it comes to thinking specifically about pets' reactions to fireworks. Have you ever watched a toddler fall down in a room full of adults? If the adults gasp when the baby falls down, it almost definitely will start crying. However, have you ever been in the same situation but none of the adults have reacted? I have, and the baby picked itself up like nothing bad had happened. What does this have to do with animals and fireworks? Strange as it may sound, an owner's reaction to fireworks may affect a pet's fear behaviors. If an owner anticipates that their pet will be scared or engages in lots of protective or dramatic comforting behaviors, it may actually increase their pet's fear behaviors. This just goes to show that any issue involving animals will be more complicated than we assume. After all this, you might be wondering if there are any alternatives to the big traditional fireworks displays put on by communities for celebrations like the 4th of July and Canada Day. I'm happy to report that there are, at least a few. Alternative fireworks can use a process called compressed air propulsion that shoots the firework materials up into the sky with a big burst of air. These are nice because they get rid of the issues of smoke and perchlorates associated with traditional fireworks, and they're probably also quite a bit safer for the ground crews setting up the display. However, they still make a lot of scary noises, and their colors are still produced using the heavy metals I described, so I guess compressed air fireworks are only a slight improvement. Something that sounds better to me, and also very futuristic, are laser light shows. Lasers are specialized lights that can be directed and colored without any combustion or heavy metals, making them a much quieter, cleaner alternative to traditional fireworks. However, studies still need to be done on whether or not laser light shows are safe for birds and bats using the same airspace as the show. You know, there's always something else to consider. Regardless, I hope I've inspired you to think a bit more about the fireworks displays you enjoy this summer. If you feel motivated by your concerns for pets and wildlife, consider lobbying your local government to switch from traditional fireworks displays to one of the alternatives. What do you think about proposed bans on fireworks sales to private citizens that some states and countries are considering? Do you think they're a good idea to help keep people and animals safe? Let me know how you feel about these issues down in the comments. If you liked this video, don't forget to like it. If you didn't like this video, please share it with someone who would. And if you'd like to support the Roving Naturalist, remember to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon. You can also follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and you can find me on Dungeon Dwellers on Twitch every other Monday playing Dungeons and Dragons. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.